TIFU by framing an 8-year-old kid and ruining his life. Of course it wasn't actually today. This happened in the early 90s. The names have been changed to protect the innocent. The rest is exactly how it occurred. I was in second grade and constantly getting into trouble. One day the teacher MRS Jake announced that it was time for SSR silent sustained reading and we were to pick a book and head out to the courtyard. I decided I was too full for SSR and that hiding under my desk for an hour was somehow better than reading in a sunny courtyard. So I had. All the kids left the room. I overheard MRS Jake asked the parent assistant to make some copies of the pop quiz. MRS Jake headed outside with the class. I kept hiding and watched as the assistant came back, put the quizzes on the desk and went outside. I emerged from hiding and went over to MRS Jake's desk. This is when my impulsive 8-year-old brain truly began to shine. I took the teacher's adult scissors and cut the pop quizzes to bits. It was only after I was done that I even considered that I would get into trouble. So I put the teacher's scissors on Paul's desk. Paul had been mean to me a while ago. Grabbed a book, slipped out the door to the courtyard, and sat up against the wall reading without anyone the wiser. Yet again the glory of my undeveloped brain shone. By the time SSR was over I had completely forgotten about cutting up the quizzes. The class was now seated at their desks inside and I was spacing out as usual when I heard the yelling start. MRS Jack, why did you do this? Oops, I realized I guessed wrong and left the adult scissors on Jack's desk, not Paul's. A small error that would echo for years. Jack, I didn't do it. MRS Jake. MRS Jake, don't lie, Jack. It will only make it worse. Jack, I didn't do it. MRS Jake, you're in trouble, Jack. Jack grabs the scissors and raises them towards the teacher's face. No, MRS Jake, you're in trouble. Holy duck. I was completely unable to process what had just happened. Jack ended up getting restrained on the floor by the parent assistant and the vice principal, screaming the whole time about how he didn't do it. I didn't see Jack for a couple of weeks and when he returned to school everyone called him Scissors Kid for the rest of the school year. The school shut down that summer. It had been closed before and only reopened that one year to accommodate overflow while construction on a new school was wrapping up. My class was split between several schools when we attended the next grade. I never saw most of them again. I forgot Jack's name and could only remember him as Scissors Kid. 11 years passed and some things that should not have been forgotten were lost. History became legend. Legend became myth. I had just started college. One of my high school friends joined the army and was preparing to leave for Iraq. His parents invited me and another one of his friends over for a send-off dinner. His mother said a prayer before we started, asking God to keep her son safe. It's clear she's getting emotional. His dad tries to lighten the mood and follows up the prayer with a comment that he'll be just fine as long as he's got some scissors. The joke is lost on the other friend and I. The soldier's brother and parents start laughing and see that their inside joke needs some explaining. His mom starts to tell the story about how her son threatened his third grade teacher with a pair of scissors. Thus began the biggest holy duck moment of my life. Jack was Scissors Kid. Jack clearly didn't think the joke was funny and immediately starts denying cutting up the quizzes. His parents keep teasing him and obviously didn't believe their son. The guilt was too much. Jack was about to go to war. He might die. I had to come clean. Me was this MRS Jake's class. Jack, how do you know that? I explained myself. Told the story of how I thought I was framing Paul. Jack told me I ruined his life, that they made him take anger management classes. His mom defended me, saying that I may have framed Jack but I didn't make him threaten the teacher's life. Jack went off to Iraq. We fell out of touch as most high school friends eventually do, but I'll never forget the insane serendipity that will forever link me to Scissors Kid. Too long didn't read I framed a small child with anger issues, causing him to threaten his teacher's life, and I only came clean years later right before he went off to war. I was once pulled into the vice principal's office in 8th grade. A younger student at the elementary school across the street had picked my picture out of the last year's yearbook as the person that ran straight at him after school the day before and yelled, "I am going to beat you up." Of course, I hadn't done that. I was with my best friend and both our moms. Luckily, the vice principal knew my mom, and I told him he could call her and verify that I hadn't threatened anyone under her watch. I was dismissed and dismayed at the accusation. I kept thinking about it and later on in the day, remembered that I had raced my friend to his car, and while we were racing, I was running in the direction of another kid, and I did yell out to my friend, "I am going to beat you." So mystery solved. Growing up, I often imagined being in line somewhere and hearing someone tell the story of how an 8th grader threatened to beat them up, how he pointed out who it was, and no one believed him. 24 years later, and there I am, sitting on the toilet retelling this story on Reddit because it hasn't come full circle yet. I had a kid that used to run laps in elementary accused accused me of stalking and trying to mug him on the playground directly after he broke my nose for standing in his way, never really learning what happened to him. Last I heard, he may have been arrested for drug charges. Though, a kid reported me for breaking his thumb in middle school, which I did. What he left out was that I did it because he stole my backpack, and when I sneakily took it back, he decided to punch me in the breasts repeatedly. On one punch, I caught his thumb and bent it back until I heard a snap while he screamed. I feel zero remorse. He was 2 years older than me, and punching a girl in the breast stuck him. He deserved it. When I got called to the principal's office to explain, I was crying because I thought I was going to be in trouble. I mean, I did break his thumb and I admitted to it. The principal told me everything was okay. I was right to defend myself and sent me back to class. He got a broken thumb and suspended for 2 months for assaulting another student and sexual assault, and I got in no trouble at all. Honestly, I think the broken thumb was probably punishment enough, along with the fact that I am sure his parents were super pissed to learn their son was hitting a girl, but I was just relieved to not be in trouble. Edito, and since the incident happened on the bus, he wasn't allowed to take the bus anymore. His parents had to drive him to school every day. Why was the teacher so certain Jack did it? Because the scissors were on his desk. Surely whoever did it wouldn't leave the scissors on their own desk, which is exactly what happened. Teacher sounds dumb, to be honest. When I was 16, I took my GCSE exams. In one of my exams, a kid scrawled my name on a desk. Later in the day, I got pulled out of class and was directed to the table with my name scrawled on it. The teacher who pulled me out of class looked at me incredulously and was like, "Explain this." I was a straight A student. Told her it obviously wasn't me because I wouldn't be stupid enough to write my own name on a desk. I then pointed out that this end of the hall was where the foundation students sit. Foundation papers only go up to grade C, basically the papers who cater to lower achievers. She looked at me for a moment, then realized she looked like a complete fool. Edit, I also pointed out to her that during exams we had to sit in alphabetical order, and that it should be fairly trivial to figure out who sat there earlier in the day. She looked pretty embarrassed to have not thought of that. In secondary school, someone scribbled my name, my mobile number, and the message "for free blow job call me" on my desk in permanent marker during recess. A teacher saw it when we got back to class. Guess who got punished for it? My kindergarten teacher thought I wrote on the counter because there was a letter E and I had to sit out in recess to clean the counter. I didn't do it, and to this day I know I didn't do it because it was before I came in that morning. I didn't throw a fit, but it sucked being blamed for something I didn't do and to miss recess. Everybody pathologizing this kid without considering the fact that it's an 8-year-old with an incomplete perspective on social norms being put in an incredibly frustrating situation by being falsely accused of something that he doesn't have the language skills to defend against. It's a bit of an overreaction for sure, but if he just raised some scissors and didn't try to attack the teacher or anything, then it makes a lot more sense. I feel like the fact that he ended up having to be restrained and that the adult said that the teacher's life was threatened implies that he did more than just hold up the scissors. If that was all he did, there would have been no need to restrain him. They would have tried talking him down first. He must have lunged or did something more. So going through the comments, I read two things. 1, 8-year-olds are ducking stupid and would leave evidence on their desk being too ducking stupid to hide it or place it somewhere else because they don't expect to be caught since they are ducking stupid. After they read a story about an 8-year-old hiding evidence on another's kid desk to blame him for the crime. 2, if an 8-year-old is throwing a tantrum because he got wrongly blamed for a crime he did not commit, he has anger management problems because he should definitely know better. Do you always have classes with different kids every time, or how does the system work in the US? I can't imagine not recognizing someone's name who I was in second grade. If we were again in the same class in high school, the area we lived was rapidly growing. New schools were constantly being built and the districts were redrawn a few times. I am still not 100% sure this was second or third grade, but I know it was the only K-6 grade I had with Jack. I met him again in 8th grade. We were good friends and hung out a lot for the next 4 years, which is why it was so crazy when the dots finally connected at that dinner. I'd been over to his house so many times over the years and no one ever brought up this story until then. Balls for admitting to the mistake. You could have just as easily took that to the grave. Also, as ducked as this is for Jack, as unfair as it is to be blamed and punished for something you didn't do, something anyone with siblings may have experienced, the fact that a third grader did make that turn with the scissors and go after the teacher is some heavy and not normal shit. There is a non-zero chance that you may have actually accidentally bumped him off of a way worse course if the anger management therapy was quality and helpful at all. Or maybe you made it worse and he's going off to commit war crimes. I mean, I hate to be so dark and blunt here, but I also don't want to make it sound like OP accidentally did the Lord's work and that makes the initial act okay, if that all makes sense. Reminds me of a time back at my school. They had the elementary and high school in the same building. Elementary had this play money system they earned for getting 100s on tests, offering to help clean the classroom. Act, they would spend the play money on random shit, toys and school supplies. While none of it really applied to the high schoolers, they left the prizes on display in a gym taking up our already limited space. So high schoolers started to steal from the table and throw it in their lockers. In between classes, I was taking a shit in the boys' restroom was right next to the office, and as I was coming out, I overheard that they were getting the boys together to empty their lockers to search for the stolen shit. Well, I went back into the bathroom and grabbed everything out of everyone's lockers and threw it all in this kid's locker, who was always trying to rat out everyone, then snuck out the back and rejoined the group. The look on everyone's faces when they were opening their lockers to find none of the shit in there was so good. Then we got to the rat's locker. Everything was there. Going forward, the teachers did not believe him whenever he tried to rat on someone. This reminds me of when I was about 6-7 years old and I decided to cut a chunk of my hair off in class, and then knew I would get in serious trouble for it, so blamed another kid. Told the teacher he just came and cut it off while I wasn't looking. He spent the rest of the entire day in the naughty corner of the classroom, and I am not sure what happened after that. Something very similar happened to me. I was framed by this kid for something that I didn't do, and no one, not even my parents, believed me. I got in phenomenal trouble and he played victim through it all. Years later, when he was an adult, he came clean to my parents. They still didn't believe me and said that he was just being nice. To this day, they blame me for it. It has all but destroyed my relationship with them. Very frustrating. But all may I blame my parents most of all. Let the lesson be, children sometimes lie, but if they keep on and on insisting that they are innocent, trust them. Thanks for watching. Consider subscribing for more videos.